Oh, fuck. You can't see my face at all. So I do apologize about the poor lighting. I'm gonna see if I could change this real fast. Just give me a moment. Oh, fuck. I need to get more lighting. I need to get better lighting than this because this is horrible lighting. This is even worse. Oh, my goodness. Oh, hi. Okay, so I'm just gonna try it right here. I'm gonna try and do this. I would have to actually undo everything. Give me just a moment, please. Sorry, it's so dark. It's gonna be a hot bulb. Yeah. Trust Tiki Bomber to do this without being prepared to actually get proper lighting sources in because these are the things that I do to myself. I still need to invest in a better lamp or a light source for when I actually do my recordings, probably even a better camera. And while I do have a camera now, its lighting reliability is a lot worse than my cell phone, so I'm sticking with my cell phone for right now until I could get everything else taken care of. Okay, almost done. There we go. Aha, now to put my shirt back on. Woohoo! That's what you guys all want to hear. A topless bomb. Okay, so let's turn on the light. Oh, that is so much better. All right, so let's get back to this topic because this is going to be an interesting one for you fine folks. Hello, YouTube. My name is Tiki Bomber, and I'm coming at you because I actually want to talk about some things I've been hearing a lot of. Internalized misogyny. I keep getting that phrase, and it literally means that I am so brainwashed by the media that the men have control over, to the point where I don't even recognize what misogyny actions are being inflicted upon me, especially when they've been inflicted upon me. You know what? That sounds very, very similar to me, only it's not internalized misogyny. It's called internalized misandry. The point where people are inflicted with the ideas of what men are supposed to be like and how they are supposed to react and all this other stuff, to the point that they don't even realize what they're saying or what they're doing. And there are plenty of male feminists who actually have this definition. Excuse me. They hold on to this definition and they don't even realize it. The things that they're standing up for women and saying that women are the weakness and men are the evil, vile scum lords and all that other stuff. That's internalized misandry right there. All right? And I have not seen anybody use this phrase before. Or if you have, I haven't seen you come across and using the phrase before. So if you've been using this phrase, good on you. We need to spread the word about this because internalized misandry is damaging. It is harming. It is making men suffer simply because they're men. Some good examples of internalized misandry would be Stephen Shives. You know, the fucktard who like did two five things about MRAs that he didn't like and like repeated about four of those five things in the second video. The guy who doesn't understand how generations actually are set up and how they work. Or about, well, a lot of things. A lot of Steve Shives' videos are like, I don't know, they're weird. But the point is, he does identify as a feminist. He believes that men are the evil scum lords, or at least the men who are fighting for his rights are the evil scum lords, and thus is literally an idol or an icon for internalized misandry. There's a few other ones. I've seen Sierra McCord, who's a honey badger. I seen her video on a feminist called Justin, who was literally stating that men are evil and that feminism is for men. But men are evil, but feminism is for men. No. That right there is another example of internalized misandry. Pretty much any guy who sits there and says that they are a feminist or that they are supportive members for feminism is being documented or is being classified as an internal misandry. Because let's face it, women like Sierra McCord or Shoe on Head or even Lauren Southerns, Christina Hoff Summers, which is a feminist, but she's a fucking awesome feminist. you know, they're categorized and told, even myself, I got told this too. We're told that what we're saying is internalized misogyny because we believe that these men and these boys deserve the rights that they do not have. And yet when men are told that women need these rights and stuff like that, and that men are the problem, because, you know, we're being told that women are the problem. Well, yeah, women are the fucking problem. You either get off your ass and go work for yourself for a change, or you could stop relying on a man to support you, or stop relying on a man's bank account for help, or anything that involves men. You know, we should start our own movement. Women against women going their own way. Why? Because fuck men. Well, you know what? That's okay, because at least then you wouldn't have like a trail of men following after you, like men going their own way. They didn't really get a whole lot of women going after them, but that's a whole different thing. Internalized misandry is something that is heavily involving on the feminist toxicity that is in the movement today. And that feminist toxicity is strongly saying men should be the ones to support the women. Men should be the ones who take care of the women. Men need to stop hitting the women. Men need to stop raping the women. Men need to do this with women. Men need to stop doing that with women. It's men, 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 men. That's internalized misandry. I saw a post on Facebook the other day where it says, like, menopause, menstruation, and one other word that begins with men on physical women conditions. And their phrase was, do you see how every problem starts with the word men? Well, no, that's all related to women. So what we could do is reword these phrases, since it's all physically related to women, to womenopause, womenstration, you know? Because then that would make a lot more sense since it's related to the female body. However, the word men or man is a reference to us as a being, as a race, or not as a race, as a species, you know, like human. But that's not the reason why this video is being made. Internalized misandry needs to be spread out. It needs to be documented. You know, you see male feminists saying that they need feminism because it's for them and it's for protecting women and all that stuff. That's internalized misandry. Make sure to spread the word. Put it in the comment section below. Put in hashtag, because I deleted my Twitter account. I am not supporting their trust committee. I am not supporting their silence of the free speech. I've literally just distanced myself from Twitter. So what you can do is you can go to Twitter and create the hashtag internalized misandry. And I'm going to make sure, you know, you can make your own videos. What do you think internalized misandry could also represent, also mean? I could give you some examples of what an internalized misandry is. The fact that a man cannot hit a woman even when she strikes him first. That is internalized misandry. Or how about men holding doors open for women? Internalized misandry. Men pulling chairs out for women. Internalized misandry. Men picking up the tab for a very expensive dinner or a date. Internalized misandry. Men having to bank out money to support women on doing whatever it is that women are doing. Internalized misandry. You know, just to throw out some examples. And hopefully we could get the word to spread out, maybe spread out faster than the internalized misogyny word, and literally stab it at the feminists for trying to slander men even further than what they need to go through. Until next time, this is Tiki Bomber signing out. Peace.